Welcome back to my channel. This is Christina at Homeschool and Grace. And today I'm really excited to share with you my 2020 goals. I can't believe it's 2020. That's like crazy. Let's see, what was I doing just 10 years ago? I was the mom to one and now I'm mom to five. It's crazy. How much can change in just a decade? It's amazing. So I've been seeing lots of people sharing, lots of other YouTubers, I should say, sharing their goals for this year and their words for the year. And so I thought I would share my own. So I wanted to start out with sharing what books I plan to read this year. Now, this is just for me personally. This is not my kids read aloud. This is just for mama. So I don't have a super big stack. Maybe I'll share the stack. Okay. Here we go. See, it's not that big. So to start out, I've got this little book. And you're like, what in the world is that? It's so beat up. It had a cover, but my three-year-old tore it off. It's Daily Help, and this is by Charles Spurgeon. I don't even know how old this is. I went and looked it up, and you can find this on eBay if you're really interested in it, but it's just little daily devotions. I started it last year, probably in October or something, and I'm going to continue it, and I hope to read through the whole thing this year. He's awesome. I mean, you can't go wrong with some Charles Spurgeon in your life. Next, I'm trying to finish up this book for myself, The Magician's Nephew. For some reason, I have started this, I think, twice and never finished it. And I'm like, I just want to read through this one. So I'm going to read this. And if I finish this, I'm hoping to start the next one, which I think is The Lion, the Witch, and the Wardrobe. I'd love to read through the whole series. I don't know if I could do it all this next year, but they are pretty short. I probably could do it. For Christmas, my husband got me Little Women. And we are a house of Little Women. So I'm super excited to read through this one. I'm already four chapters in, so I love it. It's so good. It's a delight. This is kind of like another devotional, I guess. 100 Days of Inspiration. This is by Trim Healthy Mama. I got this when they had their big, Cyber Monday. And I got it on sale, so I thought, well, might as well give it a try. So it's written by their mom, Nancy Campbell, and I really like her podcast. I can't remember the name of it. Above Rubies. And then Pearl and Serene, and then Pearl's daughter, can't remember her name, Meadow. Anyways, so this has been, I've only read about two of them, so I'd like to read through it all this year. Another one I started last year and I want to finish this year is Pilgrim's Progress. This one's in today's English, so it's much easier to read and understand. I'm notorious for starting books and not finishing them, and my goal is to actually finish these books. So this one is, I'm to page 73, but we just watched the movie with our kids this last year, and so I'm excited to just read it all the way through. I know the story well, so that makes it easier to get through. This is another Christmas gift from my husband, Hinds Feet on High Places with a devotional. It's kind of, these two are similar in that they're both about your Christian journey, your walk as a Christian, your journey, and just being on the path to God. And so this one I feel like is pretty heavy. I have to take it very slow in bite-sized pieces. So I started this again last year. This was in December. So I'm, again, four chapters in. I tend to get four chapters and then I pick up another book. So anyways, and then lastly, my Bible. I have read through it completely once. I tried to do it last year and then I had my fifth baby and it was too much to read through it. So My goal is to read through it again this year. So if you are thinking about it, like, hop in. Let's do it together. I use the Our Daily Bread app. They have a part that says, they have a small section that has read through the Bible in a year. So you read like about 3 to 4 chapters in the Old Testament and 1 chapter in the New Testament. And I know it sounds really intimidating, like that is a lot to read. But once you get going, you want to read more and more. At least that's how it's been for me. I don't want to put it down in the morning. It's actually hard for me to like, okay, I gotta go be a mom. I can't keep, you know, sitting at Jesus' feet. I gotta get other stuff done. But it's been a blessing in my life, and I think it can bless your life too. And it's so good to read the book. So that is another goal for me this year, to get read all the way through again. So that is all the books I have for this year that I want to read. I will most likely be adding more in throughout the year. You know, getting books, finding books. I've already got a couple books I keep putting on my Amazon wish list because I love books and I feel like I can't get enough. So, and I try to read as much as I can. Normally it happens at night, but you know, not all the time. So some other goals for me this year is we just got a piano. If you follow me on Instagram, you can see our new piano, and I'll insert picture here. Okay, so this is our new piano. This was given to us. It is such a blessing that I'm starting to play more. And so my goal, or my, I don't know, resolution, except that means, so I went and looked up the word resolution. And if you don't know what that means, because I was like, really, what is a resolution? But it's having the firm decision to do something, or firm resolve to do something. And I didn't realize it was like this firm. So I need a little more loose resolution. So my goal is to learn the piano this year more. So I used to play the piano. I took 4 years of lessons as a kid and retained a little bit, but not much. And it was not as enjoyable. Well, now I really enjoy it and I really want to grow my knowledge in piano and be able to play more. And I'd love like to have, you know, time with my kids where we're singing and I'm playing the piano. Like we did a little bit of that this year with Christmas carols and it was so fun. And I just think like, oh, that'd be so cool to learn more old, you know, hymns and just songs, you know, from movies that we could all sing together, you know, like those silly, you know, Little Mermaid movies or mermaid songs or something. So I'd really like to do that. So my daughter is learning piano as well, but she's in the beginner stage and I kind of have a little more knowledge. And so that is one of my big goals this year, is to learn to play a piano more. Another goal this year is to finish school, to finish the curriculum. Isn't that all of our goals in some way? We hope to finish the curriculum. So I think we can do it. We will be starting back this next week for week 12. And then our goal is to just get to work. And so hopefully we can get through as most of the curriculum as we can. And obviously we show ourselves grace if we can't, but I would really love to be able to do that. So that is my homeschool goal. Also, for my daughter to finish her beta math book in Matthew C, and to move on to Gamma is another goal this year. So that's for my fourth grader. For my first grader, the goal for her, or for me, for her, would be to learn to read. How should I put this? Become more fluent in her reading. She is definitely wanting and desiring to learn to read, and I think that is a goal that we can attain, getting her fluently reading. And so I really think this next year she's just gonna jump off and just get into reading, and it's gonna be, I think, a lot of fun for her because she wants it so badly. So I really think that'll be a great goal for her. The goal for my pre-K-er, Hannah, is just with her speech therapy, for it to continue to go well and for her to recognize her letters and numbers more. I think that would, that's an easy goal to attain this year also. And then for my preschooler, just, what's my goal for my preschooler? She's three. To not cut her hair anymore. To not sneak candy. She's my little sneaky one, so she gets quiet and you're like, uh-oh, what's happening? So maybe some character qualities we gotta work on. She's just funny. So if you follow me on Instagram, I'll share some more pictures of our kind of day-to-day family life, and she's just a sweet little blessing, but she is busy, 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 and quiet about it. And let's see, for my baby, my goal, just to walk. She's walking, but very unsteady, and so she's learning to walk more and more, and so just that she can fully be walking and we can be done crawling. Obviously, that's a hard one because every kid walks, every child walks at a different time, but yeah, just encourage the walking and no more crawling and picking things up off the floor because she's down there near it. That would be lovely. Okay, so I've gone through what I want to read this year, our homeschool goals, and lastly, our marriage goals for this year. My marriage goals for this year is for more date nights. I would love to do more date nights. It's kind of hard sometimes to get sitters with all five of the girls, for all five of our girls. So I'd love to do more date nights. I would love to pray together more. And lastly, just growing our YouTube channel. So this is not just my YouTube channel. My husband does so much to help with the YouTube channel for Homeschool and Grace. He is my editor. I do no editing. Praise the Lord. He is a blessing to do all the editing because I don't think I would get any videos out if I had to do the editing. So make sure you give this a thumbs up because he is my wonderful editor. And also, it has become just a fun little project for us to work on together and just looking into, you know, he loves the more technical side of it, so upgrading our equipment if we can, and editing software, and he's all into all of that. So it's just been a fun hobby for us to do together and just to continue to be able to grow this together. So I just hope that we can do that and continue to grow this channel and that it can be a blessing for you guys and for our marriage because it's kind of fun to do something together like this. So that is our marriage goals for this year. So I hope that you enjoyed this video and I hope it was fun to see what we're planning on for this year and our goals and what are your goals for this year. I know people don't necessarily like to say goals anymore, but we can have goals. It doesn't mean that we will reach those goals, but I still like to say goals. So anyways, leave a comment down below. Let me know what your goals are this year, and I hope to see you at the next video. All right, thanks. Bye-bye.